Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for August the 8th of 2020, well, it is titled Crescent Saturn. So what do we see here? Well, this is the giant planet Saturn, second biggest planet in the solar system, and we're seeing it in a crescent phase. Now, we're used to thinking of phases and things like crescents in terms of the moon, so how can other objects show us a crescent like this? Well, actually, any object that does not emit light by itself that reflects light will show phases depending on the perspective. So we tend to think of them as the moon because of the way the moon orbits around the Earth, and sometimes it gets between us and the sun, and only small portions of the illuminated part are facing towards the Earth. However, for Saturn being further away from the Sun than the Earth, we generally see Saturn as fully illuminated because it is always opposite, away from the Sun in the sky. So it's always, this lighted portion is always pointing towards the Earth. Now, however, if you travel out in the solar system and out beyond Saturn and look back, you could actually see Saturn go through a complete set of phases, including the crescent phase that we see here. So here we see the left-hand side slightly illuminated as the planet is reflecting sunlight, and we can see that the light is casting back on the shadow. So off to the right, we can see the planet casting a shadow over the rings. So the rings appear to disappear when we look off towards the right-hand side. However, the rings are still there. They're just the light from the sun can no longer reach them to illuminate them as it does around the rest of the rings. Now, normally from Earth, we would not be able to see those shadows because they would be blocked out by the planet itself. However, from the perspective of the Cassini spacecraft that took this image more than a decade ago, looking at this is able to see not only the shadows of the planet on the rings on the right-hand side, but on the left-hand side, we can see the shadow of the rings on the planet. So if you look at those big stripes on it on the left-hand side of Saturn here, where we're seeing the illuminated crescent, those are actually the shadows of the rings. And when we look at the rings in more detail, we see that there is a lot of structure to the rings. The rings are not very simple objects. They are extremely complex. That allows us to be able to see all of these different structures created by the moons of Saturn. So the Saturn's moons actually create all this structure. Very small moons can serve to confine the rings and keep them in place. And other rings create the orbital structures that we see within the rings themselves. Now, if you take a look through the image, you can actually find a couple of the moons there. Mimas at about 2 o'clock, Janus at about 4 o'clock, as little specks of light. And if you're really good, if you can find Pandora down at 8 o'clock, it's also there as well. Now, it's a chance to be able to see Saturn right now. Saturn is pretty much opposite to the sun in the sky, meaning that it rises right after the sun sets or right around the time the sun sets, and then sets as the sun rises. So it's actually a chance to see it all night long, very close to the other giant planet in the solar system, Jupiter. So that was our picture of the day for August the 8th of 2020. It was titled Crescent Saturn. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.